Myself, Professor S.N.Kulkarni, Assistant Professor in Department of Mechanical Engineering, Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. Today I am going to conduct a video session on steady state heat conduction too. At the end of this session, you will be able to derive general heat conduction equation in Cartesian coordinates. Also, you will be able to explain thermal diffusivity and its physical significance. The contents of this video session are general heat conduction equation in Cartesian or rectangular coordinates and its reduction to Fourier, Poisson and Laplace forms, as well as will thermal diffusivity and physical significance. As we know that we have a Fourier law of heat conduction given by an equation Q is equal to minus Ka dT by dS, but this particular equation of Fourier law Q equal to minus Ka dT by dx is applicable only for one dimensional heat flow. But in actual cases, in a real practice, the heat will flow in all directions in solid. Therefore, we require to derive the general heat conduction equation in three dimensional coordinates. For that purpose, let us consider the rectangular element, infinitely small rectangular element or parallelepiped made up of solid through which the heat is generated at the center of the body. Let us assume that the thickness of this rectangular element are dx, dy and dz parallel to the axis x, y, z respectively. Let us assume that the heat is conducted through this rectangular element in x, y and z direction, as well as the heat is leaving from this rectangular element in x, y and z directions, which is given by qx plus dx, qy plus dy and qz plus dz. As well as we are assuming that the heat is generated within this element. So part of this heat generated as well as conducted will be stored within the element, which will cause the rise in increase in internal energy of the solid element. Now let us see how we can write the energy balance equation for this rectangular element. We can write the energy balance equation for this element as the net rate of heat gain by conduction plus rate of heat generation is equal to net rate of change of internal energy. So this is the general heat balance or energy balance equation for this particular element. Now to find out the each term which is involved in this energy balance equation, the first term we can write it as heat conducted through the element in x, y and z direction. So these terms we have written qx is equal to minus k into area in the x direction, which is dy dz into dou t by dou x. Similarly, heat conducted in y direction is given by qy is equal to minus ky dx dz into dou t by dou y. Similarly, heat conducted in z direction is qz equal to minus kz dx dy into dou t by dou z. Now, the heat leaving in the right direction from the right face in x direction, we can write using a Taylor series expansion and approximation qx plus dx is equal to qx plus dou by dou x of qx into dx plus further terms we are neglecting. So qx plus dx we can write as using the equation for qx minus kx dy dz into dou t by dou x plus dou by dou x of minus kx dy dz of dou t into dou t by dou x into dx. So by taking the common term dy dz outside the bracket, we get minus dy dz into bracket kx dou t by dou x plus dou by dou x of kx into dou t by dou x into dx. Similarly, we can write down the heat leaving in y and z direction and the terms qy plus dy equal to minus dx dz into ky dou t by dou y plus dou by dou y of ky dou t by dou y into dy. Similarly, qz plus dz equal to minus dx dy into kz dou t by dou z plus dou by dou z of kz dou t by dou z into dz. Now, after writing the equations of heat entering and leaving the element, we can write the equation for heat generated. Now, assuming that heat is generated within the solid element, the heat generated in time dou t equal to q generated equal to q dot into dx dy dz, where q dot is the heat generated per unit volume and volume of the element is dx dy dz. Now, This heat generated and stored within the element causes increase in internal energy of the solid element in time due to. So this increase in energy we can write as dE is equal to rho into C into dx dy dz. That is density into volume. We can write, consider it as a mass. So mass into specific heat we are expressing in terms of rho C into dx dy dz into dou T by dou 2. Now combining the terms 1 to 4 as per the energy balance equation, we get the equation as dou by dou x of kx into dou T by dou x plus dou by dou y of ky into dou T by dou y plus dou by dou z of kz into dou T by dou z plus q dot equal to rho C into dou T by dou tau. This equation is called as general heat conduction equation for anisotropic material. Means the materials which have the thermal conductivity different in different direction. Whereas here we have considered kx, ky and kz are different conductivities for x, y and z direction. For isotropic material means having a uniform same thermal conductivity as k is equal to kx equal to ky equal to kz. This case is a practical case for homogeneous material. The above equation gets simplified as taking k common and considering it as a constant, k into dou 2t by dou x square plus dou 2t by dou y square plus dou 2t by dou z square plus q dot equal to rho into c into dou t by dou tau. Further, this equation we can simplify as dividing by k throughout, we get this equation as dou 2t by dou x square plus dou 2t by dou y square plus dou 2t by dou z square plus q dot upon k equal to rho c upon k into dou t upon dou tau. Now this ratio of rho c upon k we can replace in the form of one property, and the property is called as the thermal diffusivity. That is equal to alpha is equal to ratio of k upon rho c, which is the ratio of thermal conductivity upon heat capacity. And if we replace dou 2t by dou x square plus dou 2 by dou y square plus dou 2 by dou z square using a Laplace operator del square, the general heat conduction equation in Cartesian coordinates we can write del square t plus q dot upon k equal to 1 upon alpha into dou t upon dou tau. This is a simplified form of general heat conduction equation for isotropic material. Now if we consider the different cases, case 1, if we consider the heat conduction without heat generation, then the above equation reduces. Without heat generation means q dot will be equal to 0. This of the above equation becomes del square t equal to 1 upon alpha into dou t upon dou tau. This equation is called as Fourier equation. The case number 2, if we consider as the steady state heat conduction with heat generation. Now when we say steady state, the change in temperature with respect to time will be equal to 0, and the above equation reduces to del square T plus Q dot by K equal to 0. This equation is called as Poisson's equation. And case number 3, we can write it as case number 3 as the conduction, steady state conduction without heat generation. Now in this case, we can say that whenever the steady state means temperature change with time is 0, dou T by dou tau 0, and without heat generation means Q dot equal to 0. So the above equation reduces to del square T equal to 0, and this equation we call it as a Laplace equation. So these three equations we have obtained from general heat conduction equation. Now we will see the property called as thermal diffusivity and its significance. Now we have already defined the property called as thermal diffusivity and we have defined it as alpha equal to k upon rho c. If we put the proper units, the unit of alpha comes out to be meter square per second. Putting the unit of k as watt per meter Kelvin, rho as kg per meter cube, and specific heat of the material as joule per kg Kelvin, we get. Now, the significance of alpha is that we see that alpha is ratio of two properties, thermal conductivity and heat storage capacity. When we say that higher the value of alpha, the more will be the heat transmitted through the body. This may happen due to more thermal conductivity of the material or less heat storage capacity of the material. And this will happen whenever the material is having lower heat storage capacity or higher thermal conductivity. When the value of alpha is low, it means that the more amount of heat will be absorbed within the body and less amount of heat will be further transmitted or conducted through the body. The physical significance of the alpha can be understood that the steady state equation, heat conduction equation, does not contain alpha. It means that during steady state, the temperature distribution is governed by only one property, and that is called as thermal conductivity K. But whenever the system is not steady, when it is unsteady state, the combination of two properties, that is thermal conductivity and rho c, these two properties govern the temperature distribution equation, and which we have combinedly defined as thermal diffusivity. References for this session are heat transfer by P.K. Nag, Tata McGraw Hill Company, and fundamentals of heat and mass transfer by R.C. Sachdeva. Thank you.